I'm on the 14 carats, I'm 14 carat, doing it up like my eyes. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be another story time. I know how much you guys enjoy these, so I figured I would share this story with you. This one is kind of a little bit different. It is more personal, I guess you'd say, to me. It's something that has happened in my life, but you know, I guess I haven't really shared it with YouTube just because I wasn't doing YouTube around that time, so I didn't feel like it was important to mention or, you know, talk about. But I figured I'd tell this story because I'm sure some of you guys may have experienced this as well. I mean, there are a lot of people who have gone through this, so I figured you guys would like to hear my story of what happened to me. Okay, so for starters, I was engaged to my husband back in March of 2010, and then in October, I did my Miss New Jersey USA pageant, and then I'd say it was around November, December when I had visited him for a few weeks, and at that time, I could say I wasn't really like getting along with my mom. Me and my mom kind of were like clashing a lot during that time, so we would have like a lot of arguments and things like that, and I just wanted to get away, so I went to visit my husband for a few weeks and actually ended up turning into like a month I was down there. And during that time, my mom had actually called my grandmother and she was telling her that I had visited my husband and I was down there for a few weeks, but then he was my fiance. And I was visiting him for a few weeks, and my grandmother, I had told my mom, she was like, she's down there for a few weeks. Oh, she's gonna come back pregnant. And so, like, it's weird how my grandmother knew this, but my mom was just like, oh no, you know, she's not gonna come back pregnant. And also, let me actually mention this. Before I had left, because I went for a week in October, and then I came back, and then I went for a month in December. So, during the time that I had came back, I had missed my period. Like, in between the two trips to Florida, I had missed my period, and I was getting a little worried. So, I had actually went down to Rite Aid with my sister, my older sister Donna, and she had, like, well, I had bought the pregnancy test, and I took it, and it came back negative, and she was just like, well, this is a sign, you know, make sure you use protection, you know, make sure you are taking Plan B, everything, because, you know, you don't want to end up pregnant or whatever. I was only 21 then, so I was like, yeah, you know, you're right, this is a big sign, and somehow I just keep missing signs or whatever. So I was just like, whew, I'm not pregnant, you know, I'm good to go, you know. So I went down to Florida in December. I was down there for a few weeks. I'm so sorry if this is all over the place, but I'm like forgetting things and remembering things. So it's like, if I keep saying random things, please forgive me. So the day I had to come back to New Jersey from my month-long trip, I had went out to eat with my husband, and then he had to work overnight. So his dad had dropped me off that morning to the airport. So the night before, I went out to eat to Olive Garden with my husband, and then early that morning, his dad dropped me off at the airport. And so from that night all the way till when my dad picked me up from the airport, I had not eaten. And my flight was like, I'd say I got off the airport, like my flight was like 6. I ended up getting home around 10, and then I wasn't even home. Like, I remember my dad was like, I need to stop at Walmart and get something, and I'm like, oh, you know, sure, I'll walk around there with you. So it was around like 12 o'clock from the night before I didn't eat at 7 to like 12 o'clock in the afternoon. We were walking around Walmart, and all of a sudden I got like so hungry. Like, I had never gotten that hungry in my life. Like, I wanted to eat everything I saw. And I was just like, Dad, I'm like so hungry. And he's like, oh, okay, let's go get some food. And I'm like, well, why don't we just get the Subway that's right here in Walmart? And so he was like, okay. So we ended up getting like this foot long. And then we went back to the car because we were going to eat it, like, you know, on our way home. And I just remember, like, I felt like I could not make it to the car. Like, I was just, like, felt so weak and so hungry. But I made it in there, and I was eating, and I was just, like, when I was eating, I was automatically thinking something is wrong because I've never been this hungry in my life. So we went back home, and I remember telling my little sister, because then me and my little sister had shared a room still, and I told her, I said, you know, something is off. I just feel like really, I don't know, I just felt really weird. Like, I was really queasy. Oh, at the same time too, like, my sister had sprayed some perfume when I got home, and I just wanted to throw up. It made me really sick to my stomach. So I remember telling her, like, look, something is wrong. Also, while I was away, my mom decided to clean up my room, and the receipt that I had actually got from the birth
the birth test, whatever, I had stuck the receipt in the back of my dresser drawer. And she decided it was time for me while I was going to get a whole new, like, dresser set. So she had taken out, like, all the stuff from my dresser, and she found the receipt. And, you know, like, usually if you find the receipt, you're not going to read it. But my mom decided to read the receipt, and on the receipt, it had said pregnancy test. And my mom was like, why does she need a pregnancy test? And then she was automatically thinking, like, I was pregnant or whatever. And she had asked my sister. My sister was like, oh, I don't know what that's for, because, you know, like, she's not trying to get into it. So when I got back to the house, my sister had actually told me that my mom had found the pregnancy test, like, receipt or whatever. And she was just like, you know, what are you going to do? And I'm like, I don't know, because I'm not pregnant. Like, then I didn't know I was pregnant. So I'm like, I'm just going to, like, deny it. Like, I'll just tell her I bought something else. Like, you know, like, I don't know. So I basically told her that, you know, I was going to deny it. So, but I did tell my sister I was feeling a little off. I told her that, you know, smells are bothering me. And I was, like, really hungry. And I said, I really do need to get another pregnancy test or whatever. So I had already had one from the other one that was, like, it was like a 2-in-1 I had bought before. So I went and took it, and it came out positive. And my little sister was with me then, and I was, like, so scared. And she was just like, you know, she was so supportive. Like, if it wasn't for Brittany, I probably would have went crazy. But she was just like, it's okay, Kim, you'll be fine, you know. And I was just like, I was so freaked out, because when you think of it, I was only 21 then, and I was not expecting to get pregnant. I kept saying, because I just finished the Miss New Jersey USA pageant, I kept saying I was going to do it until I win, or until, like, I can't do it anymore. Because, like, 27 is the cutoff for that. So, basically, I was just like, what are we going to do? And she's like, well, you need to tell Ken. I was like, all right, I'll call him first. And we called him. And he had just gotten off of work, because he had worked overnight then. He got off of work, and we called him. And I was like, Ken, I have something to tell you. And he's like, okay, what? And mind you, he's, like, halfway asleep still. So I was like, I'm pregnant. And he's like, stop joking. And me and Brittany were like, no, like, we're serious. She's pregnant. And he's like, all right, well, I'm going to call you back. And we're like, okay. Like, we were, like, really upset at him over that. But I guess, like, he thought we were playing, and he fell asleep, and he woke back up. He told me this. He woke back up, and he's like, thinking it was still a dream. So he had called me, and he was like, did you just tell me you were pregnant? Are you sure? Like, you know, like, he was just like, it was finally clicking in his head then. So, basically, he knew. But my mom, she knew of the test, but she didn't know I was pregnant. My dad had no clue. So, so what happened was, the next day, my mom came up to me, and she's like, Kim, I found this receipt in the back of your drawer. What does this mean? And I was just like, oh, I don't know. I just kept denying it. I was just like, I don't know. She's like, okay, well, listen, since you don't know, we're going to go and get a pregnancy test, and you're going to take it for me. And I was just like, no, you don't need to have me take it. I'm not pregnant. I know I'm not pregnant. It's okay. She's like, no, we're getting this test. So she took me to Rite Aid again, because literally Rite Aid was right down the street. So she took me to Rite Aid again. She came back to the house, and she's like, all right, here's a test. Go take it for me and bring it back here. And I was just like, oh, crap. What am I going to do? And my sister, the whole time, my sister was standing there like, oh, gosh, like, you know. So I was just like, I wasn't ready for her to know. Like, I don't know. I was just like, maybe this isn't happening. Like, she does not need to know right now what it is. So I took the test. I went to the bathroom. And instead of, like, I peed, but instead of, like, peeing on the stick, like, before I peed on the stick, I dipped it in the water. So, like, it looked like it was wet, but it wasn't wet. So then, I showed it to her, and it showed up negative. And to her, she was just like, no, I'm pregnant. Like, in her mind, she just knew I was pregnant. I guess it was like a mother's intuition. So she was just like, you know what? Here, you're going to take it again. She's like, and you're going to pee in front of me. She's like, because I know you're pregnant. And I was like, oh, crap, my life is over. Like, there's no going back from here. You can't, like, I don't know how to explain it. You cannot not pee in front of a stick in front of someone. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, she's gonna see that I'm pregnant. So, like, I just remember being so scared. I went inside the bathroom, and I sat down, and I peed on the stick or whatever, and I handed it to her. And I literally, like, as soon as I handed it to her, I walked out and I was standing out there for like 2 minutes and my sister was just like, what are you gonna do? And I'm just like, I don't know, because she's still in the bathroom waiting for it. And then when it changed, she called me in and she was just like, Kim, it says that you're positive. And I was like, yeah. And she just was like, from what I remember her crying, but I remember her saying, like, you know, I'm upset over the situation because, like, I wasn't married yet. Like, technically I was engaged, but I wasn't married. We hadn't set a date. We were engaged for almost a year, but we still hadn't set a date or whatever. So, to her, it was like, you know, it was really serious about, like, having a baby before you are married. And so she was just like, I'm upset, I'm very upset over this, but it's still a baby, you know, it's my grandchild, I'm gonna love it regardless, you know. And she was just like, I wish you had told me instead of me finding out this way. And I had started crying too, because then she was just like, I'm gonna have to tell your father. And that's when I was really like, oh my gosh. Like, you know, like, it's some things, like, you can have your mom find out about bad things, but when it comes to, like, I don't know, like, I guess I'd say I'm kind of like a daddy's girl, so, like, with my dad finding out, I felt like I really disappointed him, and so, like, that really made me sad. And she was just like, you know, I need to speak to Ken about this, see how he feels, you know. Like, she was very, I don't know how to explain it, because the way she is, it was very supportive. And I mean, I've always expected her to be supportive, but I expected her to be more angry than what she was. Like, she was just more, I don't know, like, it was very positive to me. Like, it was a very positive situation, and I really did not expect that from her. But, So then I remember, like, a few days later, because she didn't tell him right away, because it was, like, really big. Like, it's really hard to, like, tell someone this. So when she did tell him, I remember her telling me, like, she was just like, you know, Kim's pregnant. And my dad literally, like, she said you could see, like, the air go out of him. Like, he was just like, it was just like, you know, like, he had to stop what he was doing. He was just like, oh. Like, he didn't say anything. And so it's like, I don't know, I think, I just, looking back, I feel so bad at the whole situation. And I remember him coming down to my room after my mom had told him. And this is so personal, like, only, like, people in my family know this. So telling you guys, it's very, like, kind of, it makes me want to tear up a little. It's really hard to explain this, but basically, he was, I wouldn't say, like, before my mom, he had a family too. So it was like, he has two sons from his first marriage, and it didn't really go the way, like, you know, he had wanted and stuff like that. So he kind of knows the situation that I was in, and he came in, and he started crying. And I've never seen my dad cry before in my life, and I was just like, I started crying because I saw him crying and I knew how much it hurt him. And he's like, listen, I just want to let you know, we're going to love this baby. I love you. You know, don't feel like, you know, you have made a mistake, like you're a failure or anything. And he's like, I still love you. And, I'm going to be here for you regardless. I'm always going to be here for you. And through this, like, the whole time he was crying and I was crying, and it was just like, it was so much. So yeah, that's basically how my parents found out I was pregnant with Sean. And me and my husband ended up getting married June, and we had Sean in August. But our marriage was like, it was like a really small wedding. So that's why for our 10th wedding anniversary, we wanted to make it like really big and like a nice occasion or whatever, because like I was pregnant for my wedding, and it wasn't like we got married for the baby, because we were already planning to get married anyways. But it was just like a different way of going about it. And I know this sounds a little off and it's all over the place, but it's because I don't know, it's really personal to me. So it's kind of like piecing little pieces together that I've kind of kept in the back of my mind, not really wanting to share with anyone. But yeah, that is how my parents found out that I was pregnant with Sean. And my parents were so supportive. Like, and if I had known how supportive they were, I probably would have came to them No, I probably wouldn't have came to them when it happened. But they are very, very supportive, and I really thank God for my parents, because without them, like, half the things that I have been through, I probably wouldn't have made it out if it wasn't for them. I know people have different experiences when it comes to telling their parents, especially if they're single or, like, you know, not married yet, that they're pregnant. And I'm just so glad mine didn't turn out as bad as I thought it was, because I remember always telling, and me and my sister always had a joke, like me and my sisters, we would always say, you know, if we ever ended up pregnant, and I remember I would always say this a lot, but we would say, like, if we ever ended up pregnant, my mom would never know, because we would end up, like, jumping off a cliff or whatever, you know, like something crazy like that, because she would just never find out. But out of it all, I'm the only one who has kids in my family. Everyone else, even my older sisters and brothers, like my brother's married, the only one who's married, and everyone else, no one has kids yet but me. So it is, like, very different. And in fact, it was even difficult to kind of tell them that I was pregnant with Layla, just because I had such an awkward experience telling them I was pregnant with Sean. So it was just like, you know, I'm pregnant. And they're like, oh, you know, they were so happy with Layla too. And it was just like, it was nice. But yeah, that's basically how I told my parents I was pregnant, or how they found out I was pregnant with Sean. And you know, honestly, if it wasn't for Sean, I would not be doing YouTube right now. And I know this sounds a little like, but like when I was pregnant, I would watch Tiffany Darling's pregnancy videos. And I remember thinking, I want to make videos too, so people can see about my pregnancy and what I'm going through. And I remember my sister was telling me, you know, you should make them. So as soon as I had Sean, I started my first videos, actually in October. I think it was like October 17th or 18th. I put up my first YouTube video, and I have videos of Sean when he was like 2 months, 3 months. I have actually made a video of Sean, kind of like Layla's first birthday video, but Sean when he was a baby and when he was born. And honestly, it was a blessing in disguise for me to have started YouTube, because this all ties kind of, this is like going off topic, but it's really a blessing in disguise that I started YouTube, because all of the footage that I have from Sean from between he was born to when he was one, I don't have. Like, I only have so many pictures, so many videos, because my computer actually ended up getting stolen when he was one, and I do not have the, I didn't back up my computer hard drive, so I just have, like, very little clips of him when he was born and things like that. And I wouldn't have had any birth clips at all if I had not uploaded them to YouTube. So that is, like, such a blessing. And overall, though, like, honestly, Sean has changed my life for the better. I am just, like, so blessed to have such an amazing little boy as my son. And I love him so much. And I would not trade him for the world. Like, he is... He's so, like, to me, and I know parents say this all the time, but to me, he's, like, so perfect. I love him. But I would recommend to use protection, guys, because that is something I'm not good at doing. But I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I will have some more story times up for you. I wanted to do a story time on my pageant experience. If you guys were interested in hearing about that, definitely let me know. Or if you guys have any story time suggestions, put them below, and I will definitely... make a story time about them. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.